keep informed. Stay plugged in. Read Next on Sunday and every day of the week.
Hello and welcome to Next News. My name is Jane Usen. The Nigerian Union of Journalists, NUJ, has advocated for the introduction of a life insurance policy for its members to assist them in performing their duties without fear. The Deputy National Secretary of the Union, Abiodun Ajiboye, said the introduction of the policy had become imperative following the increase in the number of dead journalists. He made the call on Thursday in Awka at the inauguration of the executive members of the Anambra branch of the union. Mr. Ajiboye said many journalists had lost their lives through assassinations and road accidents in the process of carrying out their assignments. Nigeria and South Africa will soon sign a memorandum of understanding that allows transit between both countries visa-free for some nationals. Vice President Goodluck Jonathan Mead gave the indication in Cape Town, South Africa on Thursday at a dinner organized by the Speaker of the South African National Assembly, Maxwell Sisulu, as part of activities marking the 10th year anniversary of the Nigerian-South Africa Binational Commission. Mr. Jonathan said that the signing of the document will be one of the highlights of the Nigerian leg of the celebration, which will hold in Abuja in a fortnight. He said holders of diplomatic passports will be the beneficiaries of the agreement. Justice Mojisola Ishola of the Federal High Court, Lagos, has threatened to jail Miguel Ewerem, son of the late Senate President Evan Ewerem, if he continues to disobey her orders. She gave the warning on Thursday at the resumed hearing of the suit filed by the widow of the former Senate President Vivian Ewerem over her husband's property. Mr. Kennedy Osunwa, counsel to Mr. Ewerem, told the court that the justice's order had not been carried out because his client traveled out of the country to attend to his health. The Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation and the Petroleum Pipeline Marketing Company on Thursday denied the allegation of a 75 million naira bribe leveled against them in a media report. Aminu Babakusa, the group executive director of the corporation, made a denial at a meeting with the House of Representatives Committee on Petroleum Resources Downstream in Abuja. The general manager of Petroleum Marketing Company, Reginald Stanley, said the company does not intend to monopolize importation of petroleum products into the country. The National Drug Law Enforcement Agency, NDLEA, has apprehended a driver who loaded his lorry with 1,360 kilograms of cannabis at Okada in Ovia Northeast Local Government area of Edo State. The agency's commander in the state, Oke Ihebon, who disclosed this on Thursday in Benin, said that the suspects involved in the incident were arrested on Tuesday. Olympic and world sprint champion Usain Bolt believes the tainted image athletes have acquired after several high-profile drug cases in the past few years will clear as time goes by. 22-year-old Jamaican said this at a news conference during the launch of ZS Foundation on Thursday. In the past decade, American sprinters Marion Jones, Tim Montgomery, Justin Gatlin and Kelly White, plus Britain Dwayne Chambers, have been banned for doping offenses. And finally, the UN Security Council on Thursday extended its sanctions imposed on Cote d'Ivoire for another year. The news agency of Nigeria reports that the sanctions include an arms embargo and a ban on any state importing rough diamonds from the West African country. The council, which unanimously adopted Resolution 1893, also renewed targeted sanctions restricting the travel of individuals who threaten the peace process in the country. Thank you for watching Next News. Do remember to log on to our website 234next.com for more details.